Okay, well, I've been pretty rubbish at doing the videos this time. It's so bright here today. But today is, I think, the 3rd or 4th of March. And we are building the garage. So, Sadie in, Jesus and Salvador. And they are doing the garage. So I've set this out myself. I've got material myself and I'm going to build it myself. I'm going to design the roof myself. I've designed the steels myself. Based on what I can find on the internet and based on my experience previously. So yeah, the major RSJ goes above, which is 203 by 190. And then I'll weld some T-sections onto that. And I put these rations, which is like, I don't know how to describe it in the UK, we don't have it, but these rations that sit in between the T sections, and then on top of that you put concrete, and on top of that you put the Spanish tiles. So I'm putting a full Spanish tile roof on there. So it's about 40 square meters of roof over the whole, no, 80 square meters of roof over the whole thing. And each square meter probably weighs about 200 kilos. Yeah, right? No, not as much as that. I can't remember the exact weight, but I worked it out and the steel's going to be okay. But yeah, very, very heavy. Very, very heavy roof. So, and I'm putting on some rubber matting. So, because this, remember, I don't know if I spoke to you before on the video, that this side is independent to this side. So, but I want the roof to remain as one unit, one complete structure. So it means that when I build the piers or the columns, or they will be independent. I've got rubber matting that's connected to the pier and then rubber matting connected to the steel. And then hopefully if there's any movement, it moves on the rubber matting and not on the concrete wall. So that's my design. I'm sure it'd be okay. I'm just going to go around because Tim is here as well. Tim broke his Pecker bit, this massive steel end, which you can hear the knock, knock, knocking.
I think the other half is buried in your garden, mate, so I had to improvise.
That actually snapped, so we've been waiting about 4 or 5 days for that to turn up. And so we are breaking out the pool. Not too close because you can't hear a word I say. So we're taking. A bit more of the terrace has been taken up. Look at that. Breaking out the pool. Yeah, so back again, typical construction is when you're breaking something out or you're digging down into the ground, you just come across things that you just not really prepared for. And when we did the pool, great intentions at the beginning, yeah, smash the pool out, get a new pool, put it at the right depth, put it square to the house, put in the expansion tank or the balance tank, and then we got exactly what we want. But when we take the pool out, the pool is actually, it's really thick in terms of concrete, because originally there was a pool here, which was concrete and then painted blue. And that leaked, so instead of dealing with that problem, they just decided to put reinforcement in the pool and then pour more concrete. And the concrete they poured was incredibly strong. And that's where the problem is now. So we're breaking through two layers of concrete. One is possibly 200 or 300 mil thick, and then the other one was 200 mil thick. So we've got a lot of concrete to break through. But when it's done, and then we've got a proper foundations to the new pool, and fingers crossed it will, it won't sink and it won't leak. And yeah, all good. It's so bright out here that, I mean, I don't know if you appreciate how bright it is. But yeah, lovely day again. Let me see Teddy. Turning everybody off that goes past the gate. He's boy, isn't he?
Wait, what's up?
He's a funny old dog. So yeah, Teddy and I have been spent the last few days. I might as well walk down here. So, oh yeah, we had a problem with the water pump in our little cassetta. That had stopped, got a lot of iron in it from the water, and it packed in. And when we turned it on, when I'd come back after 4 months, turned it on, overheated, broke one of the propellers, so I had to take it down to Malaga and get that fixed, but it's under warranty, so that's good. So yeah, this bit area here, we've cleared all the stone, prepared all the land ready for the grass. And then since I've been here, Sally's been had a lot of water come off the land and end up coming down here, move some of the stone, all the soil had gone onto the road. So it's been a bit of a pain. So what we've done is I've now concreted all the top piece, this side of the fence, so to stop any weeds and to basically stop the water from taking too much soil. This concrete is slightly higher than this land the other side. The fence has moved, it wasn't put in like that, but I'm not redoing the fence. And then we've mortared all between the stone, which makes it all look nice and neat. And then my neighbours, I believe, are going to concrete all this road now, because they really like what I've done. It's all for their benefit. And then again, the palm trees are all going down here. Now, I've ordered the palm trees. They're coming in 2 weeks, massive lorry and with an IAB crane on it. And then it's having a big trailer with it as well. And we dig all the holes. So I'll video that. We dig all the holes ready for it. And then the driver, I pay the driver basically to park up and then drop each of the palms in the holes that we form with Tim and his machine. And then we'll backfill with Tim. And that way we can drop them all in, get it all done and dusted really quick. Rather than put them in a big pile and then try and move them from a big pile into the holes. Just doesn't make any sense. So I've agreed that with the driver, and I've agreed that with the owner. It's going to cost us €40 an hour, which I think is well worth it. Yeah, so things have progressed, things are moving on really quick.